this tutorial, we will see how to get started with Thea for Cinema4D and learn the basic workflow that will help you become familiar with the interface. Starting with our scene, the only thing that we need to do to start rendering is to open Thea Darkroom. Thea Darkroom can be found on the Thea Render menu. This is the place where anything related to rendering and post-production takes place. The top bar gives you access to the basic render settings, like rendering mode, engine, resolution and staging tools. There are two rendering modes. The interactive mode, where any change to the scene is transferred in here, and the production mode. The production mode does not have interactivity and should be used for rendering final images. For this scene, we will go with interactive mode. We will select the Presto AO engine, which utilizes both CPU and GPU and is ideal for fast feedback. From the drop-down menu, we can select a predefined resolution or select custom, which uses the current resolution from Cinema4D settings. Let's press the Start button to see interactive mode inside Thea Darkroom. Navigating the scene can be done either from the viewport or directly inside Darkroom. The default render engine that Thea for Cinema4D uses is Presto AO, which eliminates the scene with ambient occlusion. This is the reason that we see the scene rendered without lights. For more realistic results, we will now change to Presto MC. Presto MC is also CPU and GPU accelerated, and it can be considered as an unbiased-like engine. The reason for seeing black in the frame buffer is due to the fact that Presto MC is not using ambient occlusion and there are no lights in the scene. Let's see how we can add physical sky and image-based lighting. Creating an environment with Thea for Cinema4D can be achieved by using the sky object along with the Thea sky tag. As you can see in the darkroom, Thea sky has been enabled. Inside the tag you can find all the settings that allow you to change the Thea sky. From the illumination drop-down menu, we can switch from Thea sky to image-based lighting. In here, we can define an HDR or EXR image by clicking on the Browse button. Thea Materials can be accessed from the Thea menu in the Material tab. In here, we can create a material from scratch by selecting New Material, or use the presets below to create materials like plastic, car paint and more. For our first material, we will select the plastic preset and apply it to the scene. Let us create a diffuse material as well. We will apply this to the bottom part of the cap. In the diffuse material properties, we will add some reflection to it and change the diffuse color. Thea Material Editor has many settings to play with, and they will be explained in an upcoming tutorial. We will go on and see more details about Thea Render settings. Thea Render uses the resolution that we define inside the render settings. For this example, we will set the resolution to 720p. To have access to Thea render settings, we have to set it as the current render engine. We can do this by selecting it from the drop-down menu. We are now able to select the production mode, so that we can render our final images in the picture viewer. A very important note here is that the render image in the picture viewer is being displayed with double gamma correction, and in order to avoid it, you should always go to Project Settings and uncheck linear workflow. If you do not follow this workflow, you will get washed out images compared to Darkroom. We are now ready to start rendering in Picture Viewer. Production rendering can also start from inside Thea Darkroom. We simply choose Production, select the render engine from the menu, and make sure that we have Custom from the Resolutions drop-down. This concludes the Getting Started video for Thea for Cinema4D. Thank you for watching.